Praise the Lord, everybody.
Come on, let me try that again. I know it's 7 o'clock at night on a Tuesday night, and some of us have turkey on the brain, but let's try that again. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. As we have come into this place and into this space to celebrate the life of Brother William Tompkins, we are here today to celebrate his life. Amen. I said we are here to celebrate his life. As he has meant so much to so many of us that are present in here tonight, but most of all, he's meant so much to his family. And his family has done a phenomenal job as far as caring for him, one. Let me say that. They have done a phenomenal job caring for him. Let me say that again, because I'm not getting enough amens. They have done a phenomenal job caring for him. Just as much as he has cared, his son and daughter cared for them when they were growing up. And so it was only right for them to do the same. And in that same fashion, they have done a phenomenal job of laying out this beautiful program. Is it beautiful, you all? These pictures have been selected to show forth the love that he has shown for his family. But not only that, they have taken the time to select this program in order of service as found in this program here. And so I believe wholeheartedly, not necessarily that my job is to be up here to be an MC, but that you have a job to do what's called to be a UC. And that's wherever you see your name printed on this program, I would invite for you to please come to the microphone. If you do not see your name printed on this program, please, 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 ma'am, please, sir, please don't appear at this microphone. Amen? Amen. Now, I know we all have masks on. But I need you to do me a favor. Look at the person on your left or on your right and do me a favor and smile at them through your mask with your eyes, with all 32 teeth you have or don't have. We can't tell because it's behind the mask. But smile at them and look at them and say, neighbor, we're going to get through this with the help of the Lord. Now do me a favor, lean on that other neighbor you didn't smile at in the first place and smile at them with your eyes and tell them, neighbor, we're going to get through this with the help of the Lord. Now come on and give God a hand praise. Our choir is going to lead us in a selection tonight. Followed by that, we will have Old Testament and New Testament scripture readings by Deacon Alderman David Moore, followed by prayer by Elder Demetrius Thomas, and acknowledgement of condolences by Mr. Cordero Wilson, and he will also go over the resolutions. Come on, let's give God a hand praise as we receive our choir. Thank you.
Amen, amen. My brother-in-law has the victory. Before I read this scripture to the angel of this house, the elder, Reverend Eric Thomas, I love you so much. To my nephew, the Reverend Javon Moore, doing a magnificent job officiating as he always does. You guys make some noise for them, please. I've been assigned to do the scripture from both the New Testament and the Old Testament. I'm going to stick to that, but I will just say this to this Tompkins family, even before my niece and nephew was born, to, especially to his brothers and his mother is in heaven, I couldn't have asked for a better brother-in-law. And I said that from day one when I met Bill, a man's man, a leader. And I thank you all so much for being a blessing. Isaiah 57, New Living Translation. Good people pass away. The godly often die before their time. But no one seems to care or wonder why. No one seems to understand that God is protecting them from the evil to come. For those who follow godly paths will rest in peace when they die. New Testament, Revelations 21, 1 through 7. And I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all, not some, I make all things new. And he said unto them, write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said unto me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. May the Lord add an additional blessing on the reading of his word, for this word is already blessed. Amen.
May we pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for this day, hard day, God, a difficult day, but yet and still, oh God, you are in control. So that we say thank you. Thank you for this life, this legacy of this great man, God. Thank you, oh God, for his child, oh Lord Jesus. We ask, oh God, now that you will strengthen the family in the mighty name of Jesus. Be with them, oh God, in this grieving process, God. Be with them, oh God, even when the phone calls stop, oh God. Be with them, oh God, when they walk by the way. Be with them, oh God, when thoughts enter into their minds, God. Be with them, oh God, when they feel like they're losing hope and strength. In the mighty name of Jesus, God, show your power to be strong and great and might. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Father, we pray a blood covering over the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, have your way in the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, encourage the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, strengthen the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, oh God, help the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, anoint the family. In the mighty name of Jesus, love on the family. in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Show up with the family in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Endure with the family in the mighty name of Jesus. Answer the questions of the family, God, in the mighty name of Jesus, oh God. Have your way in this place, God. We pray for a celebration, oh God. We pray that you will be with them henceforth, now and forevermore. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The family of William Tompkins would like to thank everyone for your calls, your texts, Facebook posts, and all others. We really appreciate everything that you have done for us and for being there by our sides in this time. We would like to also acknowledge cards from the Sanctuary Choir of Greater Harvest Missionary Baptist Church and Momentum of Greater Harvest. All other cards the family will acknowledge at a later date. Resolution, Chicago, Illinois, Tuesday, November 23rd, 2021. The pastor, officers, administrative staff, and members of the Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church take this time to express our love to the entire family of Brother William Tompkins. As believers, we have the wonderful assurance that when we die, our souls go into the presence of Jesus Christ in heaven. Even through the shadows of death, my entail, physical suffering, and the sadness of being separated from our loved ones, it is a blessed pathway. This is because for the child of God, the road leads home. We believe Brother Tompkins' pathway should be described this way. Brother William Tompkins walked with God every day. They walked together through the storms of life and the raging waters of sickness. They walked together through the good times and not so good times. One day they walked and walked until Brother Tompkins felt weary and noticed that the sun was low and the day was far spent. But he said, "My, I must hurry back to my house because it is getting late." Then God said, "Brother Tompkins, you have served me well. You need to rest. It is so much closer to my house than it is to yours. Come and go home with me." And so God took Brother William Tompkins home with him. It is with this truth in our hearts and prayers in our lips that we remember Brother William Tompkins with love and thank God for loaning him to us for a season. Lovely submitted by the Fellowship Missionary Baptist Church, the late Reverend Clay Evans, founder, the Reverend Charles Jenkins, pastor emeritus, Reverend Reginald Wayne Sharp, Jr., senior pastor. November 23rd, 2021, resolution. Let not your heart be troubled. Ye believe in God. Believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. That where I am, there ye may be also. John 14:1-3. The tribe of Dan would like to extend our warm sympathy of the passing of Brother William Tompkins. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints. Psalms 116:15. Brother William Tompkins will truly be missed. We, the tribe of Dan, extend our love and prayers to the family and especially to his children. And I heard a voice from heaven saying unto me, "Right, blessed are the dead, which die in the Lord, from which hath forth. Ye said the Spirit, that they rest from their labors, and their work do follow them." Revelations 14:13. Humbly submitted by the tribe of Dan, Greater Harvest Missionary Baptist Church, Elder Eric Thomas, pastor.
Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforts us in all of our tribulations. 2 Corinthians 1, 3 through 4, King James Version. Whereas our eternal God, Father of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and our Father, has called upon himself the dear soul of Mr. William Tompkins, brother of our member Deacon Albert Tompkins, brother-in-law of Sherry Tompkins, and uncle to Siobhan, Charisse, and Christopher Tompkins. We are bound to the entire family through Christian love and sympathy. We share their sorrow as our sorrow, and we enfold in them in our prayers. Be it therefore resolved that we, the members of Trinity United Church of Christ, pay our respect to Mr. William Tompkins in his celebration. Be it therefore resolved that we, the members of Trinity United Church of Christ, pay our honor and respect to Mr. William Tompkins in the celebration of his homegoing as we commend the family to the care and keeping of the one who promised never to leave them or forsake them. And be it further resolved that we pledge to continually be in prayer with the family in this their time of bereavement. Be it finally resolved that a copy of this resolution shall be mailed to the family and a copy shall be placed in the archives of Trinity United Church of Christ. Respectfully submitted, our sisters and brothers in Christ, the Deacon and Internal Security Ministry, the pastoral staff, the Reverend Dr. Otis Moss III, Senior Pastor, the Reverend Dr. Jeremiah A. Wright, Jr., Pastor Emeritus, Trinity United Church of Christ. This the 23rd day of November in the year of our Lord, 2021.
Amen. Another resolution? All right, program now calls for a musical selection from the choir. Amen. Come on, let's give them a hand as they come.
Let the church say amen. Let the church say praise the Lord. Put those hands together and give God praise tonight. Come on, put some power behind that hand clap and give him glory. Sister Diane, we love you and thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus.
He loves me, I love Jesus. No. when the storms are raging, He'll be your shelter. Where He leads me, I will follow. Glory to God. I love Jesus, and He loves me. Hallelujah. I love Jesus. Glory to God. And He really loves me. Hallelujah. I love Jesus. And He loves me. I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. When He leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. I love Jesus. I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. When He leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. When He leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, when He leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. Whenever He leads me, I will follow. I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. Wherever He leads me, I will follow. Hey, I love Jesus. He loves me. Hey, I love Jesus. He's my Savior. When the storms are raging, He's my shelter. Oh,
Sunday afternoon, sitting back in the back of the church, you know, just bopping a little bit on that type of music right there. Because the truth of the matter is that wherever the Lord leads us, us as those that follow after him, those that love him, it's our duty and responsibility to follow him. And sometimes it may be tough, the places the Lord may lead us. But the truth of the matter is that if we got the Lord on our side and if we're going through it with him, we can make it through the tough stuff we're going through. Come on, give God a hand clap of praise. If you know that the Lord is with you. This time now, our program calls for remarks. And we will have in this order remarks from Miss LaGuinia Macon. This is Brother Bill's Tompkins' niece, his nephews, Mr. Cornelius Moore, Mr. Jeremy Jackson, Mr. Cordero Jackson, in that order. Come on, you all, let's give God a hand clap of praise and encourage them as they come.
Good evening, you all. I want to thank you all for coming out tonight to help us send my uncle home. This is a celebration. I had a whole speech prepared, and up here I'm drawing a total blank. So I will say, most of my family didn't know my Uncle Billy was my first employer. Job I love and took pride in, which my sister got me fired, but that's neither here nor there. I used to always think he was, like he worked for the CIA because he always had these like suits on, and I swear he would pop up on me in the most random times in life. And some of them times I was not doing, anyway, you get what I'm going with that. I was not doing what I was supposed to be doing, and he would be the one to pop up on me. I do want to say again, thank you all for coming out. And I want to say, just show love. Do everything in love. And I am thankful because the last time I saw my uncle, I got a chance to tell him I loved him. So don't wait to this moment, till you see somebody stretched out before you, to say you love them. Always tell them you love them.
How y'all doing? Hey, you know my name, baby. All right. So on behalf of me, my brothers, family, a little bit of everybody, old Uncle Bill. I'm going to tell you something, Uncle Bill. Uncle Bill was a big old blessing. Like I said, I had a lot prepared to a million different things. I ain't drawing no blank, just got too many words. So with Uncle Bill, one thing I loved about him is he loved music, all kinds of music. And one of his girlfriends in life, later in life, became Alexa. And him and Alexa would play music all day and all night long to the max value. And when I say they played, and one of the people he always played, and he got mad when Alexa wouldn't listen, and that's Walter Beasley. And every night, he'll try to play something, and she wouldn't listen. And we'll go in there, we're like, what you doing? And he was like, he ain't listening, you tell him, you know. So we get to playing what he want to play, and he turns to that max volume, and that's what's going to wake you up early in the morning. Definitely one thing I can say about my Uncle Bill, he had some patience, and he showed love. And I seen him many day, throughout his day, whatever he would do. He took a moment of doing his day, a moment of silence for himself, and he would read his word. I would definitely see that. It was one day he didn't have his Bible, when he threw a fit around that house. His Bible was left at the church. He forgot it at the church, and he was running around that house mad because he didn't have his word. And we had to find him a little word. And when he got his little word, he was calm and he was cool. Growing up with him as my uncle, I mean, the first time I met him, he was my first black Santa Claus. You know, seriously, first big man I seen him, my first black Santa Claus. And me and him, many days, we'd be waiting there, calm my auntie. He taught me some patience. Because she be in there talking, and we be in that backseat. And man, we just be waiting. We learned some patience. One thing I definitely could say with his last year, right after my aunt passed here on this earth, he had a ball. He did what he wanted. Anything he tell us, he did it. If we didn't tell him, he did it. We tell him to sit down, he don't sit down. He went out, and I want to say thank you to Bill's other kids, all the other children that always stayed at the house. You know, they took him out to eat, you know, to go to the show. Anything he needed, there was always a village around him to make sure things was taken care of and that he was properly taken care of. And I do thank all the other children, y'all know who y'all is, for that, all right? I want to say let's have a good time. When you get home, play some Walter Beasley for my uncle. You know, just jam out, play some good music, whatever you feel, play some good music, have a good spirit, and just a good old time. And eat something good, too, because he likes to eat good. I don't know if y'all know that Bill likes to eat good. All right, so y'all eat, y'all have fun, and y'all dance. All right? All right, what's next on the program? What's happening?
Mic on now.
not today is just only a celebration. Thank you, Javon, for when he told us to look at each other and smile. Ever since I've known Bill in 92, I was a little kid then when I first met him before he married mine. No matter what this man was going through, no matter how his day went, he smiled. If he had a long day at work, was hungry, he didn't complain about it, he just smiled. He'd be, nephew, you know, go fix me something, you know what I'm saying? I'd be like, all right, I got you, Aunt. But to Diane D'Angelo, I know this may be a hard time, super hard time, but remember to smile like y'all daddy did. Life is, you get your ups and downs, but he was happy. No matter what he did, he was happy. Like my little brother said, he did like to jam out. Talking about some music. I think that's another reason why I listen to so much music, besides being an engineer myself. But that's it for today. And we're going to continue this celebration, because little brother done took it all, you know what I'm saying?
Bill-like fashion, we're about to listen to some more music, but actually see it expressed in dance form. Amen. Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise for Cordero Wilson as he leads us in worship.
Thank you.
program now calls for tributes from the family, from Mr. Albert Tompkins, this is Bill's brother, and Miss Diane Tompkins, his daughter. Come on, let's give them some encouragement as they come.
Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord, saints. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Yes, yes. I was blessed with a true brick brother. Big brother who whooped my butt, helped me to read, helped me to add, helped me to do right. He led me and his younger brother. And we followed by example because we were raised as men to be providers and a support for our family because we followed his lead. I have an acronym for Billy, as we used to call him. B is brother's keeper because I served in the military. No one else served. But he was a support network for my wife and my daughters when I would go away. And people would wonder how I would do it. But my wife and my daughters could call on him. My brother would call on him, and he would be there. He was an inspiration to not only to us, to other men. Different brothers who may be here today, he was uplifting to his son, to his grandson, to his nephews, those in maternal, non-maternal. He was also a leader for his family. His family, he was just phenomenal. He was also a person of laughter. Even with his illness and his times of, how you say, struggle, he always found a way to laugh. And he had he could mimic John Belushi with that one eye up and that one eye down. And look at you and you just crack up. And it was just phenomenal. Y is for yoke. Because he had that bond. Even when it was tough, I followed, my brother followed. And you say, oh, well, we didn't have men that was there, but we had a big brother. And we thank God for him. We love you, brother. Thank you.
Before I say what I have to say, first, thank you, Pastor, for everything that you have done. We had decisions to make, and you came. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you to Elder Janiel. I know I booked him. Thank you for everybody that is here to celebrate my dad. First, let me say, Cadero, publicly, I want to say thank you. Literally a year ago, you moved in with us, and you have been the greatest help to us, so thank you. I always get the accolades for helping my dad and my parents, but I had a partner that I always tell my daddy I didn't ask for, but I got anyway. And, you know, when times got hard, he would get dad and take him to Carbondale, and it would be the biggest help. So publicly, D'Angelo, I say thank you for being my brother. So everybody knows my daddy was my best friend. My movie buddy, $5 Tuesday, you know where we was at, period. My refrigerator right now is really full because there's no one to eat everything. We say, Dad, don't eat it. If you want it, don't put it in a refrigerator. That's just basically how it is. I miss just going in his room and just laying on him, telling him I love you until he said it 30,000 times. I'm gonna miss bugging him. I'll never forget 10, 11 years ago when he first got sick and I came home from school and I saw him in the hospital bed and literally every tear rushed to my face, but I couldn't do anything. Like, I couldn't cry, I couldn't do nothing. And I remember Auntie Sherry, I went in to look at him and she was like, oh, he looking at you? And it's just, my dad knew me. In the state he was in, he knew who I was. It's gonna be real quiet. Cadero said, I left his Bible on the back pew where Rhea's sitting, and LDD ended up finding it. And I promise y'all, I got cussed out for 2 weeks. He knew I was going to church. Don't forget my Bible. Where my Bible? Daddy, I forgot. I'm sorry. And it was just over from there. My daddy and my mama are probably in heaven having a really nice talk about which mansion they're gonna get. One probably wanna be down further from the other. But yeah, I really appreciate everybody coming to celebrate my father's life. I'm gonna miss being in the choir stand, seeing him in the back, enjoying service. Like, for me, that was so rewarding to see that, because literally all that my dad has been through, he never stopped fighting. He kept going. He always kept going. Daddy, sit down. No, he's going to the fellowship hall. I gotta use the bathroom. Something, he was doing it. I thank everybody. I thank my Greta Harvest family, because y'all really loved on my father. He was a member before I, and y'all really loved my daddy, and I really appreciate y'all. That's all I have to say. My dad was literally the best father ever. No shame to any other daddy, but my daddy beat you. Yeah, that's all.
Albert a hand. Elder, y'all got another selection? Diane said y'all can sing whatever. Come on, let's give them a hand as they come. After the choir, the next speaking voice that you will hear will be that of the pastor of this church, this house, Greater Harvest Baptist Church, Elder Eric Thomas. We will celebrate him as he comes, but at this time we will have the choir, and after which it'll be Pastor Thomas. Amen.
Yeah. Amen. Let's say amen, everybody. One more time. Amen. Let's give the Lord praise, everybody, for what he's done. Can we give God praise for the life of Mr. Tompkins? Everybody, put your hands together. He fought a good fight, and he finished his course. Amen. Yes, he did. Amen. To my brother, amen, Elder Moore, and to Elder D, amen, Elder Thomas, and to all the elders. I think I saw our assistant pastor in the back as well. Amen. God bless you too, sir. Amen. To everybody that's here today, and especially to this family, to Diane, D'Angelo, amen, and to all of you, to his brothers, and everybody that's here, to the household of faith. It's still a good day, even in spite of what's going on. And the reason I can say that it's a good day, because this is the day that the Lord has made. And we rejoice and we are glad in it. And for that reason, we can be happy today, because this is not the end for our brother. Amen. This is absolutely not the end. And I say that for those of you who are in Christ, you understand what I'm saying, because you know the word. The Bible says to be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. And believe it or not, one day we are all going back. Now, the Bible does say that everybody won't taste death. Those of you who know the scriptures, everybody won't taste death. Some of us are going to be caught up. Amen. Some people will be at work. Some of you will be in your cubicle at work doing your thing. And when the roll is called and when the trumpet is sound, amen. Bible says those of us who are alive and remain shall be caught up together to meet them in the air. Those who have already gone before us, we will meet them in the air. The old saints said it like this: we just have to be prepared, because heaven is a prepared place for prepared people. Amen. Amen. Look, I'm not going to be long before you. Give me like 4.5 minutes, and I'm going to sit down. Amen. I told Elder Moore before I got up, I said, people have a span, and I don't care what you do. When that span is over, that listening span is over, you can put oil on them and water and prophesy. Amen. Once that span is gone, there's nothing else that they want to hear. Amen. So I want to be quick tonight, and I just want to leave a word with you that I believe. Choir, thank you. Let's say amen for our choir. Amen. I do want to salute, though. I do want to salute his children, because in a day where people are putting people away, people don't take time out to care about people like they used to. And you may not believe it, but children don't take care of parents like they used to either. And so I think that they deserve a hand of applause for taking care of both of their parents. For taking care of both of their parents. And hats off to you. Saints of the Lord, you only get one set of parents. You only get one mom, one dad. My father's still here with me, but my mom is going to be with the Lord. And I'll tell you, amen, even today, amen, I still miss her like it was yesterday. And if you have a good mom, if your mom is in your life, amen, cherish her. If your father's in your life, cherish him. Respect them. Love on them. Make sure that they don't want for anything, because when they are gone, amen, that's it. And so I want to applaud you today for doing what many people are not doing today, and that is sticking with it. I want to say that because there was never a time that we saw Diane here in particular, when we see them at church and she would come in with them, amen, or her brother, amen, that they were always well taken care of. She took the time out. They took the time out to make sure that they were good. Even if she had something to do, they would make sure he was in his place right there on the end. Amen. Right there on the end. And I thank God for you all. Amen. Look, the Bible says this really quick. to Amen, Alderman Moore. God bless you, brother, preacher, deacon, prognosticator, all the things. You all love him, brother. Amen. Thank God for him. Amen. For being here, and to everyone else, all the other ministers who might be in the house. I want to just read something really quick to you and get out of your way. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 5, amen, for we know that if our earthly house of this tabernacle were dissolved, we have a building of God, a house not made with hands, and it is eternal in heavens. Somebody say amen for the reading of the word. Amen. I have something real quick to tell you, amen, that my subject would be, if I'm really going to preach, it would be a win-win situation. Amen. Somebody say amen. Amen. Tell somebody else, this is a win-win situation. Amen. Really quick, amen. In life, there are many options that we have, period. And the reason I believe that we are people of options is because things in the earth realm fail. I don't care what it is. Cars fail. The moment that you buy a car, when you drive off the lot, you all know what I'm going to say. Immediately, it begins to depreciate. Not only that, some of us have spare tires in those cars. Have you ever had your spare tire to go out on you? Amen. As wonderful as they are alternatives to that, to the main tire, but you can get a flat, amen, even on your spare tire. Somebody say amen. Not only that, our homes, amen. You buy your home, the moment you step in, it seems like stuff just starts to happen. And those of you who rent, amen, thank God you're renting right now. Because those of us who are homeowners, amen, it may seem like a glorified thing, but tell somebody there's always something going wrong. Amen. Somebody say amen. Alternatives, amen. Not only that, but stuff breaks. Amen. Stuff breaks. Amen. Your dog gets sick. Cats get sick. Amen. Your favorite jewelry, you lose one earring, can't find it. Guess what? You can't even wear the pair because you only have one now. Somebody say amen. Not only that, but people fail. Amen. As much as you may love people, friendships fail. And marriages may fail. Amen. Fellowships fail. Amen. Many of us, we say, well, I guess if you leave me, amen, I'll find somebody else. Tell somebody that don't always work. Hey, somebody say amen. Even in friendships, they fail. Amen. In government, we have alternatives. Amen. If something happened to Joe Biden the other day, our president had to have some work done in the hospital. And for about 85 minutes, amen, the vice president was the president. For about 85 minutes, she was the alternative to our president for 85 minutes. But guess what? Something could happen to her during that time that she was the alternative. Because tell somebody, alternatives fail too. Glory to God. Tell somebody, alternatives fail. Amen. You may have another plan, but guess what? Your plan can still fail because we are in the earth realm. Somebody say amen. As much as we love our president, President Biden, that's my guy, amen. Somebody say amen. But guess what? President Biden can fail. And as much as we expect it from him, amen, his approval rating, even right now, his approval rating is not so good. As much as we wanted from even President Obama, we thought he was going to be, amen, our savior. But guess what? There are things that he couldn't do that we expected him to do. There were things that we wanted him to do that he still didn't do. Somebody say amen. Technology fails. As much as we pay for our cell phones, somebody say amen. As much as we pay for computers, amen, they fail. They lock. They do all kind of crazy things. The internet fail. How many of you have been somewhere and you couldn't get a connection? Somebody say amen. Amen. And even our bodies. I know some of y'all, amen, you think you're fine. Amen. And you got all your teeth. You got all your, you got good eyesight, good hearing. But guess what? Tell somebody it's on the way out. Glory to God. And I heard somebody say, don't you speak that over me. Amen. Guess what, honey? It's going to happen whether I speak it or not. is going to fail, amen. But we do have some options, amen. Your teeth fall out, you can buy some new ones, amen. Your hair fall out, you can get some new hair, amen. Expensive hair, some of y'all got it on tonight, amen. Somebody say, glory, soul wins, they call it, am I right? Somebody say amen, amen. If you're like me, my barber, he sprays my hair on every week. Amen. I'm in the middle of the week, so it's not as dark as it normally is on Sundays. But that's my alternative. But sometimes my alternative sweats out. Sometimes my alternatives, amen. Sometimes I brush it out. And sometimes when I shout, I'll shout it out. That's my alternative. Somebody say glory to God. Somebody say glory to God. Some of you, amen, some of you don't have an iPhone, amen. I'm trying to get you saved, amen. Some of you are Android people, but we're praying for you. We're praying for you that the Lord will deliver you. And some of you had a nerve to have flip phones in here, amen. Tell your neighbor there is an alternative. Somebody say amen. Amen. Somebody say amen. Our bodies will fail. Technology will fail. Everything will fail. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. My back, I've had issues with it. Amen. It's a sign of older age. Amen. I'm getting older. Amen. But Paul talks about, amen, what we would deem as an alternative. He says, if there's potential, he says there's potential for these bodies to fall and fail. He says, but if this body, if this house, glory to God, of this tabernacle were dissolved, amen, he says, guess what? I have another building. He says, it's not made by hands, glory to God, but he says, it is eternal in the heavens, amen. And I thought about it, amen, for years. Elder Moore, I thought about it as an alternative. If something happens to this body, I have an alternative body. But the truth of the matter, God gave me a little revelation. The truth of the matter is it really couldn't be an alternative body in the realm of the spirit, because alternatives have the potential to fail. It's only an alternative to me because I don't know what the end is going to be. But when I say amen and when I speak of the word of God, amen, the Bible says I have another building. Who gives me this other building? God is the one who gives me the other building. And so therefore, it couldn't be an alternative, but it is his plan for me. In other words, if something happens to this body, I have another body that is assured to live eternally. And this is what has happened to Mr. Tompkins the other day. He got another body. Because the Bible says God knows the end from the beginning. And God says that everything that God does for us in the eternal realm is forever. It's not an alternative body. But it is the plan that he has that once this life is over, he says, I have another one, not an alternative one. Glory to God. Tell somebody, amen, I got another building. And what I love about it, he said, this building will never break down because it is not made by hands, but it is eternal in the heavens. Somebody say, glory to God. In other words, I have a win-win situation. Glory to God. We wanted God, amen. I wanted God and you wanted God and all of us wanted God to heal Mr. Tompkins on this side. But God decided not to heal him on this side. The other morning, amen, when Diane called, I rushed to the hospital and I couldn't even get to him to pray and lay hands or any of that. God said, don't worry about that, glory to God, because I'm going to lay hands on him, glory to God. And when I lay hands on him, I'm going to do one thing. I'm either going to heal him on this side or heal him on the other side. But tell somebody, this is a win-win situation. Somebody say, if God had healed him, I'd be shouting right now. Because God is able. But guess what? God decided not to do it the way I wanted it done. And he decided not to do it the way his family wanted it to be done. But he said, I'm going to do it eternally. And so today, we're not shouting because he was healed on this side. But we're shouting because he still won. Tell somebody, I still won. I still won. Amen. This body dissolved. This body dissolved. But guess what? He still won. No matter how you look at it, this is a win-win situation. There's no loss in here. There's no loss in this room tonight. You will miss your loved one. You will miss him dearly. You will miss his presence on this side. But I'm here to tell you tonight, he still won. Because there's another building. The Bible says it's eternal in heavens. It will never fail. It will glory to God. Amen. Perfect hearing. Glory to God. Perfect eyesight. Never have to worry about anything again. Tell your neighbor this is a win-win situation. And guess what? You and I, those of us who are in Jesus Christ, we have a win-win situation with God. It's kind of like what the Hebrew boys said, and they summed it up. They told King Nebuchadnezzar, as they were in the fiery furnace, he said, the God that we serve is able to deliver us from the fiery furnace. But the win-win situation is that if he doesn't deliver me from the fiery furnace, he's still able. Tell your neighbor, somebody, tell somebody, God is still able. And so tonight, it may look sad, like a sad situation, and I know you do feel hurt, but tonight, family, those of you who are in Christ, you understand that this is a win-win situation. It's a win-win situation. God could have healed him on this side, but he said, no. I have another building for him. And when he was raised, you know what? He's going to be raised with a glorified body. That's what Jesus had when he was raised from the dead. The Bible says he had a glorified body. He was able to go through walls, and that's what happened. Somebody say glory to God. Amen. Come on, let's give the Lord praise for this man of God tonight. Thank God, amen, for his life, and thank God for the fact that he has a win. This is a win-win situation. He'll never hurt again, never suffer again. Never have to go to the hospital again. We'll see him again. So that's the other thing about this whole thing. We will see him again. And we'll praise God and worship God with him forevermore. Let me do this before I release you out of this service. Amen. Let me just offer Christ to somebody. Somebody in this room right now may not know the God of a win-win situation. But I want to introduce you to him. Amen. He's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And his son's name is Jesus Christ. I know you've heard of him, but guess what? Just in case you've never met him personally, I want to let you know that he loves you with a perfect love. Amen. And your life will change forever. I know there are those who don't believe this way. They don't believe what the scriptures say, that he is the way, the truth, and the life. But guess what? He absolutely is the way. He absolutely is the truth. And he absolutely is the life. And the Bible says, no man comes to the Father but by me. I believe the scripture, I believe the report tonight that you cannot get to the Father, amen, unless you come through Jesus Christ tonight. And so I offer him to you, not as a baby in a manger. I don't offer him to you, amen, as a myth. He's not a myth, but he is real. Jesus Christ, he did walk the earth for 33 years. He did minister and preach the gospel. The Bible says Jesus spoke of himself, amen, and quoted Isaiah 61, said, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, for he has anointed me to preach glad tidings unto the meek and to open prison doors. Tonight, I don't know what kind of prison you're in. You may be in the prison of depression, the prison of sickness. No matter what prison you're in tonight, God has come and he died for you. He loves you with a perfect love. Believe it or not, one of two things are going to happen to you. You're either going to be called up to meet God in the air, or you're going to pass from this way, and you'll taste death. Either way, your soul must be anchored in the Lord in order for you to see him again. And the only way you can be anchored in him is that you accept him. Romans 10 said it like this: if you confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus, and if you believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, that's what causes you to be saved. It's not running around the church and dancing. It's not even speaking in tongues. It is saying yes to the Lord. Lord, I answer you. I hear you. And I hear the call to salvation. So tonight, if you are here, amen, you don't have to even give me your hand. You don't even have to raise your hand. But in your heart, just ask the Lord to forgive you whatever sins you've committed. Bible says all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Everybody in here, amen. Somebody quoted it wrong and said, amen, y'all have sinned. No, it's all have sinned. All of us at some point have committed sin and messed up. But I'm here to tell you tonight, amen, that the Lord Jesus loves you and he cares about you. People might not love you. People will change. But only what you do for Christ will last. Amen. So tonight I offer Christ to you, and I pray that you will accept him. Would you do me a favor, everybody, just for a second, about 10 seconds, close your eyes, and I pray that those of you who don't know him, you will accept him by praying this prayer. Father, I ask you to come into my heart. I need you. I trust you to change my life and to accept me into the body of Christ. Even though I've sinned, Lord, I know that you are forgiver of all of my sins. And right now, I want to be whole and I want to be made righteous through your blood. In the name of the Lord Jesus. Amen. I know that's a short prayer, but if you believe that prayer, if you meant that prayer, amen, you can be saved right now. Somebody say amen. Amen. Come on, let's clap our hands. I pray that everybody receive the Lord. Somebody receive the Lord Jesus tonight. Pardon of your sin. Amen. Again, I want to thank, amen, Elder Javon Moore. Amen. For just being here with us tonight. He's at home too. Amen. And all of you who are here to support this family, you never know how much it means until you sit there. Amen. It's hard. Amen. It's easy to tell people not to cry, but until you're sitting there in that seat, amen, when your loved ones are running around, amen, and smiling at you, it's easy to say what you would or would not do. But there's something about sitting on that row and dealing with this. You need God in your life to deal with this. And so my prayer is that the peace of God that passes all understanding will keep your hearts and your minds through Christ Jesus. Let's celebrate one more time by clapping our hands, everybody. Amen. We're going to ask the Evans Funeral Home, their staff, to come. And let's thank God for them tonight. What an excellent job that they always do, ministering and caring for our families. And tonight we thank them for their service to this family and to this community. We will follow them, follow their directions. There will be a review, a final review. I'm going to ask that everyone would, again, please follow their directions as they will lead us during this final moment. Yes, amen, amen. When we all get to heaven, what a day of rejoicing.
Mm-hmm.